If your roof isn't suitable for solar panels or you simply prefer not to have them installed there, a solar ground mount system might be the perfect solution for you. In this video, we'll dive into the nuts and bolts of a ground mount system to provide you with a comprehensive guide for a successful investment in solar energy. So Larry, before we get into the differences, what exactly is a ground mount?
So a ground mount will have a couple of components. It'll have a vertical post that's in the ground. Typically, we like to pound it if we can. That's the easiest way to install it. And then there's going to be a racking structure mounted on top of that post or on that post. There's going to be multiple posts with a racking structure in between. And then on there, we lay the solar panels, typically at about 30 degrees, a pretty good angle to collect a lot of sunlight. Put our inverter on the back and then run the line to the house or to the building to the interconnection point.
Great, so a roof mount system is installed obviously on your roof. Ground mount system is installed on the ground using the racking and the system that you just explained.
Right.
So when is a ground mount system a good solution versus a roof mount?
So a ground mount's gonna be a good solution when your roof mount's maybe too small for what you wanna do.
Okay.
Or maybe your roof mount is turned the wrong way. Maybe it's like east and west rather than south. Or maybe it's just heavily shaded and you have a nice ground spot.
Possibly couldn't handle the additional weight load.
Right, yeah.
So what are some, what the pros of why would I go to the ground? Other than I don't have the space here, what are some of the real great reasons to be on the ground?
So I can turn it any direction I want.
Right.
I can face it due south. I can move it away from that tree so it's not shaded. And then I don't need to worry about it on top of my roof. If I want to do a remodel later, or I want to do something different with my building, I don't need to worry about that. It's on the ground. So those are some of the benefits of a ground mount.
Sure. So on the ground, you have can get the perfect orientation and the perfect tilt, and you have the flexibility of moving it in either direction. Larry, what are some of the downsides or the cons of a ground mount?
The main downside to a ground mount is just cost.
Okay.
And again, something to think about is the farther away that you go from your building, where you're running the wire back to, the more it's going to cost. So that's probably the biggest thing to think about. The other potential con is if you have rocks underground that it's really difficult to pound posts, that could make it even more costly yet.
Sure. On the flip side, however, if your roof is an east and west facing roof, and you can go on the ground and have the perfect south orientation, you could possibly use less solar panels to get the same production and offset some of those additional costs.
Right. So it ends up being a cost-benefit analysis.
Sure. So what goes into designing the ground mount?
So a couple of things to think about is proper sizing.
Mm-hmm.
We want to make sure we have enough panels, we understand the shade, we understand the orientation and tilt, and then it's selecting a location. You know, hopefully it's close to where you're going to interconnect to, so you don't have a really long wire run. And then another thing to think about too is animals in relation, you know, maintenance in relation to the solar array. So we have typically not had any issues with animals besides maybe a bird's nest here or there. We have gotten the question sometimes though, you know, can I put a fence around my ground mount and put my goats in there?
Sure.
Yes, you can. But if you do that, make sure that your array is high enough so that nothing's chewing on those wires.
Sure, sure. You also don't want goats climbing up on the array either.
Right. Probably not a great idea in most cases.
Yeah. All right. What about what inverters would you use on a ground mount? And are those different from what you would use maybe on a roof mount system?
Yeah. So a roof mount system, you need your rapid shutdown. We've talked about that in some other videos. So you need a device on the roof mount that shuts the power off from the panel when the disconnect is pulled at ground level. Ground mount, you don't need to worry about that. So you can just do a typical string inverter. The most cost-effective string inverter that you can get is what you can use on the ground mount. Now, if you do have a lot of shade on the ground, you still might want to consider, you know, an MLPE system like solar edge or Enphase to help mitigate that shade.
And then what about maintenance and upkeep?
A couple things to think about with maintenance. One might be soiling. So let's say your ground mount is close to a dusty driveway, for example.
Sure.
That might be something to consider. Another is internet access. Do we have long-term internet access out to that ground mount site, whether it's a wireless bridge, a cellular device, are we thinking about that? And then finally, the shade from vegetation or trees. You know, do you have weeds growing up in front of your array, maybe a cornfield, or do you have younger trees that are gonna grow up over the next 10, 20, 30 years?
Sure. Now I know we talked about cost a little bit, but let's dig a little deeper into the cost. What would either save you money by going on the ground or what would cost you more money?
Just ballpark figures. A ground mount's going to be about, let's say, 10%, 10 to 15% more than a roof mount. It's going to be even more, though, if you've got to go far, multiple hundreds of feet, back to the interconnection point.
So, Larry, give us a ballpark of what maybe a residential ground mount system would cost versus maybe a large commercial agricultural ground mount system.
So a 10 kilowatt typical residential ground mount, we're probably looking at the $30,000 to $40,000 range. And again, depending on how long that wire run is, and the other big cost factor, like we mentioned, is rock.
Okay.
If you can't pound the post easily, yep, and you got to drill or do something like that, that's additional cost. A larger 200 kW system for a commercial or an ag, that's probably going to be more in the range of like $450,000, maybe $400,000 to $500,000, somewhere in that range.
If you want to know what a solar investment would look like for you, we'll leave a link in the description below to our solar savings calculator where you can calculate and get a ballpark of exactly what solar would look like for you. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up. If you didn't enjoy the video, let us know. Leave a comment in the comment section below.